Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to create a simple model and we learn many features like extruded boss base. We will see many tricks like offset or extrude from face. Then we will see how to apply counter bore hole, how to apply cosmetic thread, how to apply machine thread, how to apply planes, and let's try to make this simple exercise. Now here in this new exercise, we are going to start with this front view. Even if you see a top view, so we will choose front view, but let's start from back side, that's better. You will see at back side 45 diameter one cylinder, the thickness here, if you zoom, 5 millimeter. Then there is one more thickness, 5 minus 15, it's 10 millimeter thick, diameter 55 millimeter. Then the inside one, 19 millimeter from outer edge. So let's try to do this. If you check section view, this is the section view, this is the 10 thickness. And here also you will see the section view. No, here we can't see those section view. So let's try to do this. Now first you have to choose any plane. So even though our first operation is extruded boss base, if you directly click this one, it will ask you which plane you like to start or you like to select. Front plane. Now click circle. Now we will draw both circle here. Let's say 45, enter. Again center point and 55, enter. Now exit. Now once you choose exit, it will automatically enter into boss base. Here come down and first I'll choose inside. See, keep end condition blind and how much depth? 5. Look, say yes. Again drop down the menu of this, select sketch 1, extrude. In selected contour at bottom, choose outer line, see, and this thickness, let's say 10 millimeter. Look, but this time we will start from, let's say from surface. I'll choose this surface. See here, surface selected. You will see the preview. It's going to start from surface. If I say yes, look, one more thing, edit. Even if you don't want surface, click offset. How much offset? 5 millimeter from this outer face or front plane. So we choose offset, depth 10 millimeter. Look, now for us is easy. The same thing extended up to 19 millimeter. So what we will do, edit the first one, edit, and this one make 19 millimeter. Look, see this thickness 5 millimeter and overall 19 millimeter. That's it. Now check here, see this outer diameter, 45 diameter is 19 millimeter up to here. Now there is one rectangle. Now let's come to front view. See this 56 millimeter, 65 millimeter, and the depth of this how much? Okay, let's 19 minus 27, it's 8 millimeter. You will see here. Okay, let's minus 8 millimeter. There is a three corners R4 and there is a hole. 4 throughout hole, 4 diameter, 3 number of holes here written. 3 number of holes and 3 number of corners. Let's do this. See this bottom. And this dimension, it is parallel to these two points. And this is perpendicular to each other. So let's try it. And I'll choose this face sketch. Now activate center rectangle. Okay. Now the length 65, press tab. 56, enter. Activate line tool. Now from something from here to center point, then here. Now let's do one thing. Let me choose both the points horizontally. Now both the lines tangent to each other. So this is fully defined sketch. Even though we can use this, if you don't want or you want to hide this trim entity, power trim, and click here, keep trimmed entities as construction geometry. See, if you trimmed, move your cursor. See, it's trimmed, but it is there. Now, you have to add some dimension or something. Okay, this is not at the hold this point and this point, hold shift key, horizontal relation. Say okay, extrude. Depth, keep end condition, blind, depth only 8 millimeter. Click the edge, you will see two options, chamfer, fillet. I am going to choose fillet and the radius is 4 millimeter. These two and this one. Say okay. Now we need to add hole here. So we will try hole wizard. Click here, simple hole. This is the hole metric. And here choose type drill size. And the hole size is 4 diameter. So let's say 4. Keep end condition. Not through all. Next. Don't click anywhere. Position. Click this face. Move your cursor and you'll find center point of this. Move your cursor. And similarly, escape key to out. Say okay. Let's measure the center distance. Go to evaluate. Now drop down this I menu. Temporary axis, view temporary axis. Click measure. Now select this axis and this axis. Now center distance 48 millimeter. That's it. Now drop down, uncheck this, refresh. Now here see I added 90 degree both side. Now let's make this 45 millimeter here the width and 45 millimeter here also along with this circle. So this is the half circle. See here, you will see the section we have, and the depth of this you will find out from here. 47 minus 27, so that it's 20 millimeter. The sketch. Now activate center rectangle, 35, tab 35, enter. This is it. Now activate here 3-point arc. Find out this point, and connect this point. Now either you can trim or the same thing, trim entity, power trim, and here check this box, keep trimmed entities. Just move your cursor. That's it. But this drawing is not fully defined, so hold shift key, let's add few relations, horizontal, then again let's say add radius, half of this 35, it's 17. See, this is fully defined. Extrude, how long we need to extrude? 20 millimeter. Keep end condition blind, depth is 20 millimeter. Merge result, if you unmerge there will be two bodies, so we want only one body, so keep merge result always. Look, now here the next thing let's add this fillet, R, two number of fillets. Then we have to add this circle. See, this diameter you will see 24 millimeter, and this is parallel to this face, and it extrude up to this body. And here the dimension 26, it is the outside distance of circle to outside of this face, this flange. See, in section view, and diameter 24. I'll choose this edge, fillet, and this is 4 millimeter. I'll choose this face, sketch. Now activate circle tool and draw one circle 24 millimeter. Hold shift key, origin point and this point make 2 points, horizontal relation. Activate smart dimension tool. Distance from this outer edge, hold shift key and move your cursor outside of this, click and drag. See, 26, okay. But you must hold shift key, then we can easily get this distance. Extrude. Here choose up to surface. What surface? This surface. Say okay. Look, the same hollow shape, we cylinder rod we have to make at 45 degree, 24 24, and at this same plane you will see in section view. I took section view H, and this is the in one line. So first we have to create a plane 14 millimeter from here to here, because this is center line, the whole center distance is 14 millimeter away from the outer face. Then 34 millimeter we have to create this sketch. Then we have to create again one plane at 34 millimeter and draw this. I'll show you how. Plane, first select this, here put distance 14, flip direction, okay. Now choose this plane, a sketch, line tool or construction tool. Draw something like 34, enter, exit. Activate the smart dimension tool, 45 degree. See, this is important, exit. Now let me hide this plane. We have to create again one plane. Reference geometry, plane, first choose this line, then this point. See, we are going to create a plane on point, and the point is perpendicular to this line. Okay, now select this plane, sketch, activate circle tool. Where is this point? Okay, this point, this is the point, diameter 24. Escape key to out. Now see, extrude. Here choose up to body, select this body. Look how this is going to connect up to this body. Say okay. Look, let's hide plane and line, everything. Mirror, reference plane, first you have to choose vertical plane, this is suitable. Feature, I'll directly choose this one or from here, boss extruded, boss base 6. Look, now here let's add counter bore hole. At center you will see a 12 diameter throughout hole. You will see in section view, this is 12 diameter throughout hole. Then there is one counter bore hole. diameter 15, depth 6. This diameter 15, depth 6. Then this is the cross section of this tapered. So diameter, here also the diameter 12 millimeter in all three directions. So we have to cover this also. And here chamfer, it's 1 by 45 degree. So let's add a hole here, hole wizard, legacy hole, and here simple choose counter bolt. Now here is easy to the diameter 12, depth is we already defined through all. Counter bore diameter 15 already defined, depth 6. Position, even if you come down here, don't need to change anything. Select this face, press center escape key to out, and you will see the preview. Say OK. Look. Now let's sketch. Now here we need to add hole. 12 diameter. Escape key to out and go to feature and activate extruded cut feature, and here I am going to choose up to surface and I am going to choose this surface. Say OK. Look. I am going to mirror plane. Right plane, it is the perfect plane. Feature, just click extruded cut one, say yes, and see both side hole is created. Now the same hole we have to create at top. Extruded cut, select top surface, activate circle tool and move your cursor near any this circular edge. You will find origin point or center point of the circle. 12, entered. Now exit. Now if you exit, it will automatically enter this surface. Surface is better option. Select inside surface, yes, because otherwise it will cut too many things. Now let's check the plane. We have one plane, not this, plane one. Section view, say OK. Look how these three holes we created. I am going to choose this outer edge, chamfer, 1 millimeter 45 degree, and this outer edge also, okay, that's it. Now let's see what else balance. Now here you will see machine thread, tap hole, this is tapped hole, M4 into 7. This is 3.3 minimum of a minor diameter, 3 number of holes. And depth of this 10 millimeter, and this is thread size 6H, depth 8 millimeter. And it is equal distance, we forget to mention here distance. But this is 4 millimeter from this outer edge. Hole wizard, here choose straight tap, metric, tap bottoming hole, okay, M4 into 0.7 pitch, blind, depth 10, up to shoulder, blind, depth, this is thread size 8 millimeter. With color, cosmetic position, I'll choose this face, move your cursor and you will find a center point of the circle and place somewhere like here, escape key to out, hold shift key and select this two. Again smart dimension, select this one, hold shift key and click outer edge and see 4 millimeter. This is fully defined sketch. If I am going to check, Okay. Now, look. Now there is some collar added or something like this. If you don't want, edit. Here, near site countersink unchecked. This one. Say okay. So see, but it's not visible. Cosmetic thread. So go to options, documents property detailing, and check here shaded cosmetic thread. Look, threads are visible. Now here you will see fillet. Here also fillet. Here also fillet. Here also fillet. And all fillets are 1.5. Okay. Chamfer we already added. Fillet. Let's add this. Again add fillet, because one time it makes difficult. Okay, these things are shown for fillet. Appearance and scene. I applied brushed brass. So this is how we did a simple example in SolidWorks. This is a good example for the beginners. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. And please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.